Year of Jubilee. How many people knows Jubilee? 50, every 50 years was set aside. There was several things that had to take place in the year of Jubilee. Number one, the land had rest. You didn't farm, you didn't plant, you didn't reap, you didn't do anything in that 50th year. The land had rest. Think about how the earth, when Jesus does come, how the land is going to have rest. The curse will be removed from the earth, and the earth will bring forth its abundance like it never has except in the Garden of Eden. Not only is this the year of Jubilee and the land has rest, but all debt is forgiven. You owed somebody something, you could have owed it to them for 49 years. Maybe you paid half of it, maybe you paid 3/4 of it, but in the 50th year, it was forgot about. Debt is clear. And then the third thing that happens in the year of Jubilee, servants and slaves are set free. Now, I didn't think a whole lot about that until I started going backwards. You ever tried to go backwards? It's not an easy thing to do. But if this is 2017 and we went back 50 years, where would that be? The year 1967. Anybody know what happened in the year 1967? There was a 6-day war. And since they had been kicked out of Jerusalem, out of Israel, in 135 AD by the Romans, Israel, for the first time, captured their capital city, Jerusalem. 1967, in a year of Jubilee, the land went back to its rightful owner. And it's all going to go back to its rightful owner soon.
Amen.
That's the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the heir of all things. But then you go backwards another 50 years. That'll bring you to the year 1917. I'm giving you all this to show you something. There's significance in what God tells us in His Word. Anybody know what happened in 1917? Israel and Jerusalem had been under the control of a Turkish empire known as the Ottoman Empire. It was the second attempt by a Muslim caliphate to try and take over the world. We're seeing the third one now. It's called ISIS. People can say, "What? Oh, we can't ban Muslims." God's going to ban them someday.
Amen.
He's going to ban them from heaven. Why can't we ban them from coming into our country and try to set up Sharia law? I've got a law, and it's in this book right here, given to me by God. Not a prophet, but all scriptures given by inspiration of God, and is profitable. It's profitable for doctrine, reproof, correction, and instruction in righteousness. All these cults in the world today. You know how the Mormons got started? They had a prophet. found a book hidden under a rock. What lives under rocks?
Snakes.
Snakes. Who said that?
I did.
Thank you, Janet. Now, one thing we need to keep in mind is that when Israel is not in the land, God doesn't keep time. How many of you have ever heard that Israel is God's clock, God's timepiece? That's why we have this age in here called the age of grace or the church age. Day of Pentecost, the church was born. We have different views of opinion as to when the rapture will take place. Somebody said it started on Pentecost, it'll end on Pentecost. I believe, personally, it'll happen at the time of the Feast of the Trumpets and Tabernacles. And God will tabernacle with us, and we'll have the Feast of the Trumpets. Okay, that's my personal opinion, personal belief on that. Now, it started, and that's why I gave you those other two scripture references. And I'm not done yet. I gave you Nehemiah. I gave you Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 25, verse 11 and 12, God tells Jeremiah to tell the people that they're going to be in captivity for 70 years. And then we come along and we read a man by the name of Daniel. And in Daniel chapter 2, Daniel had begun to read in the books of Jeremiah. And he figured out, hey, that time's just about up. What's going to happen? And then he starts having dreams and visions. And God shows him what's going to happen. But he tells Daniel, seal it up till the time of the end. For the time is not yet. In the book of Daniel, and I've been checking out all these dates. Daniel, my timeline's a little bit out of sync. Daniel was written about 538 B.C. Jeremiah was written about 606 B.C. Then you come down here, somebody turned to Daniel chapter 9. Nehemiah, I think it's chapter 2. Yeah. That was about 400. I'll get it here in just a moment. Got a paper missing. How'd that happen? Around 445 B.C. So you can see the connection between the prophets. And they all confirm one another. Now, as I traced back in time, I found out if I went back another 50 years from 1917 What would I come up with?
1865.
1867. Now, that's when it hit me. God's not keeping time here because Israel's not in the land. And I'm going to give you the timeline for that here in just a moment. But in 1867, I thought it was very... And I haven't went any farther back. I mean, I have, but I haven't put the connection of the historical events with the dates. But I do know that what happened in 1867, was the end of the Civil War. After that great war, the land had rest. You know why the Civil War didn't start because of slaves. The Civil War started because of a debt. The United States government owed France a debt. And in order to pay that debt, they were going to give Southern property away to France to pay the debt. And the South didn't like it. It wasn't because of slaves. It was because of a national debt. What's next on the list to be given away because of a national debt? Could it be your children? A lot of people think we're crazy when we say that's the purpose of a birth certificate, that's the purpose of a Social Security card, that's the purpose of this and this and this. It's a guarantee on a debt. However, the land had rest, the debt was absolved, and the slaves and the servants were set free. That's just all coincidence, though.
Yeah.
We do need to remember God here is not keeping time because Israel is not in the land. They hadn't been in the land since 135 A.D. In the year 70 A.D., the Roman general by the name of Titus destroyed Jerusalem. And then in 135 A.D., the Roman armies expelled the Jewish people. The Romans renamed the land. They called it Syria Palestina or Palestine. That's the nation of Israel. And there's still a conflict today between Israel and the Palestinians. Or, if you want their Old Testament name, it's Philistines. Same group of people, always a thorn in Israel's side, worshippers of Baal. I always liked the story where the Philistines took the Ark of the Covenant and put it in the house of their god, Dagon. And every morning when they get up and go into the house of Dagon, Dagon was down on his face before the Ark of the Covenant. They'd set him up, go out about their business, and go back the next day, Dagon's down on his face before the Ark of the Covenant. There is but one God.
Amen.
One of these days, every knee's going to bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father. And I haven't finished. I mean, I got a lot to do to finish all of this up. But here in the book of Daniel, who's got Daniel 9?
Yeah, I got it.
Start reading in verse 27.
And he shall confirm the covenant with many...
I'm sorry. Verse 24.
70 weeks are determined upon the people and upon thy holy city.
Okay. Did anybody catch that? How much time did he say?
70 weeks.
70 weeks.
490 days.
Back over here in the book of Jeremiah. Hey, listen. Every word of God is true.
Amen.
Over here, he told Jeremiah, 70 years they'd be in captivity. Now, you think God is an imbecile? He don't know the difference between years and weeks? Why would he say years here and weeks here if it meant the same thing? I pointed that out to a guy one time. He was talking about, what were we talking about? Well, we were in a discussion about the King James Bible compared to whatever version it was he used. And, it was about the sons of God. And we were in the book of Genesis. And he said, well, that's really men. I said, and why didn't God use the word men? The sons of God saw the daughters of who? Men. If they were the same, why didn't God use the same word?
Right.
They were the sons of God.
Amen.
You go to the book of Job, and that's not hard to understand, because the Bible says there that there was a time when the sons of God came before the throne of God, and Satan with them. God said, where have you been? He said, I've been in the earth, going to and fro, up and down. They were sons of God. They were angels.
Right.
They're in Genesis. I mean, to me, that's not hard to understand. Now, 70 weeks, you can go to the book of beginnings, which is the book of Genesis, and use and apply the law of first mention. Whatever God first defines something as, it remains that throughout the entire Bible. How long did Jacob work for his wife?
7 years.
Seven years.
7 years, which was determined to be what? A week. So a week is 7 years. So 70 times 7. 70 times 7 is 490 years. But in the book of Daniel, God describes it a little bit differently. Let me find it here real quick. Verse 26 in Daniel chapter 9, after 62 weeks. Well, let me go back up to verse 25. I want you to notice this. Verse 25, know therefore and understand. Now this is where Nehemiah comes in. Because that's when the commandment was given. At the time of Nehemiah. Know therefore and understand that from the going forth of the commandment to restore and to build Jerusalem unto the Messiah the Prince shall be 7 weeks. The street shall be built again and the wall even in troublous times. And after 62 weeks shall Messiah be cut off. 62. That's 69. 69 weeks puts us right here at the cross. And he was cut off. That left 1 week or 7 years to yet be fulfilled, known as the time of great tribulation. Now, in Daniel chapter 9 and verse 24, notice two things that the 70 weeks are determined upon. 70 weeks are determined upon thy people. That's number one. Which is the nation of Israel. And that'd be number two, the holy city. Jerusalem. Now, this is really where it gets interesting. If I put you to sleep up to here, I want you to understand what's taking place here. 1917. A British general by the name of Allenby. At about the time of the end of World War I, they put an end to the Ottoman Empire. The Ottoman Empire had controlled the holy city, Jerusalem. Muslims had controlled the holy city, Jerusalem. Since about 135 AD. At the end of World War I, General Allenby, who was, by the way, a Christian, put an end to the Ottoman rule of Jerusalem. General Allenby, being a Christian and knowing his Bible, refused to ride into the city of Jerusalem on his horse. He walked in. He said, that right is reserved for one man.
Amen.
And that is my Lord Jesus Christ. That happened in 1917. That had to do with the city of Jerusalem. Let me check this out. I don't want to... give you wrong information. These two timelines can be divided into 30 and 20 year periods, for a total, of course, of 50. But 20 years, I'm sorry, 30 years. 30 years has to do with Israel. 20 years has to do with Jerusalem. 20 years, or 30 years, I'm sorry, to 1947. Anybody know what happened in 1947? It was in 1947 that the UN voted to give Israel a place to be a nation. And then you had 20, which coincides with the city, Jerusalem. Where do you end up? I always liked math. And what I always liked about math was this famous saying, numbers don't lie. Is that true?
No.
Numbers don't lie. 1967 brings you right back to the Six-Day War when the Jewish people recaptured Jerusalem. Two timelines determined upon his people and the holy city. Now, let me give you these numbers right here. Of course, we know that if we were to add 50 back to 1967, would put us at 2017. But let me give you some interesting numbers. These numbers aren't going to mean a whole lot to you. But in 1897, the Jewish people held their first Zionist conference. And it was in Switzerland. They'd been scattered since 135 AD. Some of them longer than that. They had nowhere to meet, so they met in Switzerland. And they discussed a homeland. That was in 1897. 1897 plus 50 years for Jubilee brings you to 1947. 1947 plus 50 years brings you to 1997. Anybody know what happened in 1997? Well, if the Jews had a conference, the Arabs also had a conference, especially since they just got their hind end handed to them on a platter in the Six-Day War. And they had Israel, they had Jerusalem surrounded and outnumbered. In 1997 was the first Arabic conference to discuss how to recapture Jerusalem. What's going on in the world today? What did God say about the city of Jerusalem? It would be a cup of trembling and a stumbling stone. Do you know why? Let me put this to you the best way I know how. In the constellation Virgo, as it's going to line up this September 23rd. And Virgo gives birth, and the great red dragon is there to devour the child as soon as it's delivered. You read on down in that chapter, and you'll find that it's there that Michael and his angels fight with the devil and his angels, and there was no place found for them anymore. Satan is kicked out to the earth. And there's an angel in the book of Revelation that flies through the heaven and says, "Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth, for the devil is come down having great wrath." He knows he has but a short time. That all happens in Revelation chapter 12. At and around the time of September 23rd. I'm not setting a date, folks. But just what if? What if? How much time do we have? Do you have somebody that you'd like to see get saved? Somebody you'd like to see get right? How much time do you have? We don't know. I'm not saying it's going to happen here. But the possibilities are great. And if it's not here, it'll be a short time after. I believe that with all my heart. You think, what was another thing that God told Daniel? Wars and destruction are determined until the time of the end. There's going to be a little peace brought on by the Antichrist, but it'll be a little peace. Wars are determined. North Korea's firing missiles, test firing missiles. Our ex-president made a nuclear deal with the number one world sponsor of terrorism. And they're just pushing it. They're just pushing it. They're testing old Donald Trump. And they might push him farther than he wants to be pushed. I've always said, it's a good thing I'm not president. I'd give them what they want. They want a nuclear bomb? Sending you one, bud. Airmail. It's on its way. That'd be me. I wouldn't put up with that garbage from a godless, infidel nation. And we're not much better, as Jamie was teaching this morning. But I just want you to see. I hope you see and understand. And I'm still working on Nehemiah and Jeremiah, putting the dates together. 445 B.C., 538 B.C., 606 B.C. And I guarantee you, well, let me just do this real quick. Show you. I want you to understand these dates are approximate dates as to the writing of each book. Jeremiah, written in 606 B.C., and he said 70 years. Couple years off, based upon dates I've got. One of these could be wrong, but that 70 is right. You see what I'm saying? The numbers don't lie. God's word don't lie. 6,017. Now I'm going to finish right here. But you said it was happened once in 7,000 years. And you've only qualified 6,017. Anybody know how much time is involved in that gap right there? From Genesis 1:3 to Genesis 3:15, that could make up the rest of the time. We don't know how much time Adam and Eve spent in the garden. We don't know how long from the garden till they sinned and fell. It could have been 900 years. We don't know. But I do know that based upon my research, these numbers don't lie. You can go by the 20 and the 30 year cycle, 30 years for the nation, 20 years for Jerusalem, it all falls in line. You can go by the 50 years for Jubilee, which I'm going to continue to do from 1867. Find out exactly what happened. But I want you to consider very seriously. I mean, it's written in the book. And now we have confirmation that it's going to appear in the heavens. At the same time as the Jewish Jubilee in their year of 5777. We might be getting ready to get out of here. The tribulation might start, and people left behind will be running into the caves. Some of these old empty coal mines around here and say, "Fall on us, hide us from the face of him that sits on the throne."
Amen.
I hope you got something out of that. That's all I've got. Let's stand. Are you serious with God? You think it could be time we got serious?